I'll be right here waiting if you change your mind.
Yeah, so I released my album into three parts because I like to be complicated. About my pride, if I felt like going with this slow burn was the right thing to do. I think ultimately putting the songs out into smaller groups allowed each song to be heard, you know, in its own right. So part one was my invitation into the biggest story of the album, which is Something to Feel. Inviting people to step inside themselves and reconnect with their emotions and a journey that I've been on for the past couple of years and through the process of making this record. I feel like a lot of people took up the invitation. I'm still waiting for maybe some people to get back to me, but so far, so good. Without you, I chose to lead the campaign. Probably the most, you know, unsuspecting song, but I just wanted to lead with something that was the most raw and the most vulnerable song, because it spoke most strongly to the messages and the themes of what I was trying to say. Without You is, you know, a song about love and longing. So I think just the fragility in the song carried the most weight. Part two, the surrender, surrendering to the process of life, of transformation, of growth as a human being. I think that word in particular became so significant to me as an artist. And as a person, and I felt so strongly attached to it that I got it tattooed to my throat. So it's surrender. Was brave. Ultimately, it's coming into, you know, the true sense of who you are as a person. Please remember me. So we chose Remember Me for the lead single for part two. It's definitely a step up from Without You in terms of there's a lot more going on. So it's quite an epic ballad. And I think the writing, I think personally, it's probably one of the most developed songs that I've written and the most mature. The subject matter, it's almost like a love letter, you know, you're expressing your feelings, trying to build the courage to tell that person, and you put it out there and you just see what happens. They might hear it, they might not. The main thing for me was the cathartic process of writing that song and releasing, you know, all that energy and that emotion, and just letting it go so I can move on. Yes, Remember Me. But if you don't, it's okay. Part three, I named The Reveal. The Reveal is the amalgamation of each individual part coming together and forming one thing, one album, Something to Feel. It also represents the final phase after accepting the invitation and going through the process of growth and transformation. You finally step out of the water. Stepping out into the world, you're a new version of yourself and you have a new sense of power, and you understand the strength that lies in vulnerability, and you interact with people and the world differently. And yeah, it's amalgamation, becoming whole again. Being Māori definitely plays a big part in terms of who I am as an artist. I think not only because of the values and principles, you know, that I carry with me, but also, you know, creativity is in my blood and exploration is in my blood. You know, my ancestors navigated and traversed the oceans from one side of the world to the other, and I think the concept of growth and adaptability is definitely inherent in my culture. Exploration, I mean, navigating all these different parts of who I am, not just as an artist, but as a person and as a human being. So yeah, the parallel of navigating oceans by navigating my emotions. Also the spiritual aspect of my culture and how much of that, you know, plays a big part in my well-being and the way that I stand in and hold myself and interact with the world and with other people. I think the rituals, I think songwriting, performing, those are all very ritualistic to my culture and are definitely spiritual practices, and I can take that with me when I'm on stage or when I'm writing a song. So I definitely feel like it's an advantage, and I'm grateful and I feel lucky and proud to be Māori. Oh, look what you've done. I hope that when people listen to the album that they will feel something. And as simple and dumb as it sounds, I feel like it's profound and necessary. I don't write music and I don't make albums to save the world. I write songs for myself, and those songs help me go through what I'm going through. And I suppose that's the beauty of art and music, is that it's, you know, symbiotic and it benefits the creator and also the listener. So it's a cycle, and it's beautiful. If it's a thousand.